Tolemu's got some pretty impressive inventory features above and beyond what you'd expect from MYOB and Xero. These features take care of the day-to-day operational things that your business is going to encounter. And I'll rattle off a quick list just to give you an idea. We're multi-location, so multi-warehouse, we're multi-currency, we're multi-supplier, we support serial and batch tracking, we manage landed costs, we have very detailed inventory and product file records, and we handle bill of materials and manufactured items. So all of those things really mean that the product record and the inventory management system inside Tolemu is really very helpful for a lot of businesses. So let's take a quick look through an inventory record, an inventory item, in this case, gluten-free pancakes. So on our top-level view here, this could have been imported direct from an accounting system or created manually. First of all, we have our product name. We have the ability to link to a web form, an instant buy web form, that allows you to buy this product online. So you can copy those links, just email them to the customers, and they can buy the product online. No need for e-commerce or anything like that. Just works out of the box. Same with QR codes, a printed QR code. You can go and scan that. It'll display a form. Customers can buy the product. So any way that you can get a QR code or a link to somebody, text message, whatever it may be, no problem. The system handles it. Now, as I go in here, we can take a look at some of the key fields. It's probably best that I do so in edit mode. And the real interesting fields are over here. So first of all, is the product active? That's straightforward. Secondly, are we going to be showing this in the customer portal? So if it's a component or something like that, or that you do sell, but you don't really want to put front and center to the customers, you can hide this from the customer portal. Then we have whether or not we buy it or sell it. And then we have whether or not it's serial tracked. That just means whether we're going to be tracking serial numbers. Even though the accounting software doesn't do it, we do. Then we have auto create asset when sold. What this does, pretty much given away by the name of the tick box, you can set the system up so that when you sell certain things, for example, coffee machines or big expensive assets, we'll take a record of it and put it into our asset management system. The next one, physical, basically means is this a physical item that we have to pick, pack, and ship? So because we have a pick, pack, and ship process in Tolemu, we don't want to try and tell people in the warehouse to go and pick an extended warranty or something like that. So this means it's a real item that goes into a box. Then we have track stock. So are we tracking stock at all, or is it a non-inventory item? We also support the use of training courses in the system. So this is basically flagging this product as a type of product that is used to represent a training course. So if you were running regular training courses every month, for example, Photoshop for beginners or something like that, you would have one product called Photoshop for beginners, and then you'd have multiple training courses, on the first Tuesday of the month, say, where that course was run. We then have another box here, is configurable. This is used for complicated products like, say, computers, where you're selecting options or cars. So for example, if you're selling a car, you might have the option to select 19 or 21-inch wheels. You can't have both. You must select one. So we can build that kind of product into Tolemu so that you can use that in your quoting. We then have a virtual product. A virtual product is used for marketing purposes primarily. So for example, if you had, let's say, a mouse, a plastic mouse that you hold stock of, you might decide that for marketing purposes, you want to sell it as both a Mac mouse and a PC mouse, and who knows, maybe the Mac mouse is more expensive, has a slightly different description. So you can have two products that look different, sound different, have different descriptions, pricing, and part numbers, but they draw their stock from one real product underneath. I make this product basically, again, does what it says on the tin. What this also will do, though, is it will enable the bill of material system, which is like an assembly inside MYOB. That turns on the ability for us to go and make these products and manage the production process. And then finally, we have is batch tracked, which turns on our batch tracking system inside Tolemu. If I come back now to the main view, we do have an ability to place attachments on the product if we need to. We can pop those anywhere we like. And then as we go down a little further, we can see that we're able to go and put in place price breaks. So here I've got three levels. I can have multiple price breaks between each level. I can do different discount types. So this is set up as a substitute price, but I have the ability to do dollar or percentage discounts. So you could say, for example, that wholesale is 15% off the retail price. You could also put date ranges in here as well. We can maintain the stock over multiple locations, and you can see here our different locations are different in stock values. If we make it, we'll have a default bill of materials. We have a history of stock movements, and then we also have an ability to automatically create tasks when products are sold. So if you're selling a product that might require some assembly, you can generate a to-do task, for example, or an inclusion of some item to be placed in the kit. If I expand out the tab set here, we can also see we have special prices, which allows you to give special prices per customer, as well as lists that show prior times this item has been sold to customers before. So a fairly detailed product record right off the bat. If I go into a different product, let's go, for example, and take a look at the coffee machine. We can see here we have a two-group coffee machine. You'll notice now we've introduced an image here, and we can see some parts of the description. We also have here a checkbox to say we're automatically going to create an asset when we sell this item, and those assets would appear in the asset management system. As I scroll down here, we'll take a look. Because this is an item that we purchase, we now have suppliers. I have three different suppliers. Each one can have a separate price. We can also put in place sliding scale supplier pricing as well if we choose to do so. So if you get different price breaks from your suppliers, either expressed as a percentage or you know, just a unique price list, we can handle that as well. And this is an example of a serialized inventory tracked item. If I go and click inside here, I can see my serial numbers, when it was created, what's in stock, and so on. I'll now jump into a different product again, and we'll go into some macadamia oil. This is a batch tracked item, and so we can see here we have is batch tracked enabled, and as we scroll down here, it's pretty much the same. The difference is that now we have batches. And so when we take a look at these batches, we could, for example, click on side here, and we can see there's our batch number. We have 154 of them. It expires in 2025. It's in the Sydney office. Now I can also specify a bay location per batch as well, which is quite useful. Next, we'll go and take a look at a manufactured item. So I'm going to go and grab up a bakehouse brownie. So just give me a second to find that. And I think that's the one. Yeah, so this is a manufactured item. So as a result, it has a default bill of material. Now it is worthwhile noting that we can have multiple bills of material for the same item. So for example, if you'd ordinarily use 20 kilo bags of flour, you don't have it. You can use, you know, 21 kilo bags of flour, which might just be a little bit more expensive. So if we take a look now, we've got our default bill of material. We can take a look down here. There's nothing particularly more interesting or new that's been revealed. The bill of material is actually just sitting here, and we've just got one. So let's go and take a look. And first of all, at its simplest, we have all of the input materials, and we have the output product. Now it's worthwhile noting here that we can have multiple inputs and multiple outputs. So if you do very small runs where you might go and produce like what have one batch run or one process that then produces, say, three different types of cake, you don't have to run six or seven work orders to go and get to that final output. You can just run one work order that says take all of this input stuff, and then you end up with three types of cake and four samples. That can be done easily as well. The final type of product I'll show you now is what we call a configurable item. So there's a stand mixer inside here, and we'll go the Pro Mix Large. I think that's the one I need. So again, fairly sort of standard looking product, except we now have is configurable ticked up here. And as I go down, what we can do is we can see we have this section here called optional groups. So we've just got one here called stand mixer add-ons. And then if I click on that, it basically says, yes, the group's active. Now, I don't have any min or max selected there, but let's say that I wanted to enforce at least one. I would just put a one in there. And let's say that I said, well, you've got to select one and you can't select more than one. I would set the max as well. I won't do that. Now, if I go to optional products, here are all of the products that fit within that group. And so the idea here is that we can add in these various different products so that when we go and quote or sell this product, then we're able at the point of sale to go and choose all of these options, all grouped down, all by those rules. So it's quite a powerful set of inventory features that we have. We do support some interesting type of products that I think a lot of businesses are really going to enjoy.